barely standing. And take what's left. Every wall is falling. Just one breath, and you could have this beautiful heart that's ruined. Take what's left. Every wall is falling. Just one breath, and you could have this beautiful heart that's ruined. Mm-hmm.
I've held it in so long, and then when I got to the bridge, I was like, ah. That was so nice.
Eric, and Megan. Antes que todo, before anything,
les doy gracias a cada uno.
I would like to thank everybody.
Y para mí,
and for me,
es un gran privilegio,
it's a privilege
el poder estar aquí,
to be here.
Ya que él,
because he
es
Eric, hermano. It's my brother.
Y por los últimos, por el último año y medio,
and for the last year and a half,
me ha estado ayudando,
he has helped me
en la iglesia,
at the church
donde pastoreo,
where I'm a pastor
in Harvard. Y más que privilegio y honor,
and more than a privilege and an honor,
estar con mi hermano,
being with my brother today.
Y con los tres hermanos, mis tres hermanos.
The three brothers.
Gracias.
Thank you.
Eric. Me da mucho gusto.
It's an honor.
Yo sé por lo que has pasado.
I know what you've been through.
Y sé.
And I know.
Que Dios te ha dado.
That God has given you.
Hoy.
Today.
Es grande.
It's something great.
Te amo mucho.
I love you.
Y también a Megan, que va a ser parte.
And I also love Megan because she's going to be part of my family.
Familia. Bueno, como todos sabemos,
like we all know,
el matrimonio,
matrimony,
es honorable en todo.
It's a great honor.
Es la primera,
it is the first,
de las dos instituciones,
of the two institutions,
establecidas por Dios,
established by God.
Fue dada,
it was given,
en sabiduría,
as a wisdom,
para apoyar,
to support,
el orden social,
the order of our society,
y proveer,
and to provide,
por medio de una familia,
like through family,
bajo la dirección de Dios,
through God's direction,
que la verdad,
that the truth,
y la santidad,
and the sanctity,
sean transmitidas,
will be transferred,
de una generación a
from another, one generation to another,
antes que todas las leyes,
and even before any law,
de origen humano,
given by man,
el matrimonio,
matrimony,
es la base,
is the base,
de todo gobierno civil,
of every government,
y la razón,
and the reason,
para toda legislación humana,
to any human legislation.
La paz,
the peace,
y la prosperidad,
and prosperity,
de nuestro país,
of our country,
depends,
de
la observación, del matrimonio,
through matrimony.
Nuestro Señor,
our God,
Jesucristo,
our Lord Jesus,
comenzó su ministerio terrenal,
he started his ministry on earth,
assisting a una boda,
to a wedding,
y él usó el matrimonio,
and he used the matrimony,
para ilustrar,
to illustrate
su amor,
his love,
para su iglesia,
to his church.
Entonces,
so then,
la base para todo matrimonio,
the basis for every matrimony,
debe ser el amor.
It should be love.
El amor,
love,
como lo dice,
like it says,
Primera de Corintios,
1 Corinthians
13, de 4 a 7,
from verse 4 through 7.
El amor es sufrido, es benigno. El amor no tiene envidia. El amor no es jactancioso. No se envanece, no es indecoroso. No busca lo suyo, no se irrita, no guarda rencor. No se goza de la injusticia, mas se goza de la verdad. Todo lo sufre, todo lo cree, todo lo soporta. El amor nunca deja de ser.
Love suffered long and is kind. Love envied not. Love vaunteth not itself. Is not puffed up. Doth love not behave itself unseemly. Seek not her own. Is not easily provoked. Thinketh no evil. Rejoice not in iniquity, but rejoice in the truth. Beareth all things, believe all things, hope all things, endureth all things.
Así también,
so,
los maridos,
husbands,
deben amar a sus mujeres,
should love its wife,
como sus propios cuerpos,
like its own body.
Al que ama a su mujer,
whoever loves his wife,
a sí mismo se ama,
loves itself.
Porque nadie aborreció jamás su propia carne,
because nobody denied its own blood,
sino que la sustenta y la cuida,
but it takes care of it,
como también Cristo a la iglesia,
like Jesus to the church.
Por eso, dejará
reason,
el hombre a su padre y a su madre,
man shall leave his father and mother,
y se unirá a su mujer,
and will become one,
y los dos serán una sola carne,
and they will be one blood.
Las casadas,
married women,
estén sujetas a sus propios maridos.
stay subjected to her husbands.
Como al Señor.
Like the Lord.
Porque el marido,
because the husband,
es cabeza de la mujer,
is the head of the woman.
Así como Cristo es la cabeza de la iglesia.
Like Jesus is the head of the church.
Es el deber del esposo,
it's the husband's responsibility,
proveer todo para su esposa,
to provide everything to his wife,
protegerla del peligro,
protect her from danger,
y guardarla para ella en un afecto inalterable,
and take care of her of all things.
Pues así es el mandamiento de la palabra de Dios.
Because that is God's word.
Los maridos, amar a vuestras esposas.
Husbands, love your wife.
Así como Cristo,
like Jesus,
amó a la iglesia,
loved his church.
Y se entregó a sí mismo por ella.
And he gave himself for it.
La Biblia da el mandamiento.
The Bible gives the commandment.
Que las esposas estén sujetas a sus maridos.
That the wives should obey her husband.
Como la iglesia está sujeta Cristo a la iglesia.
Like
la iglesia está sujeta a Cristo.
Like the church is obeys Jesus.
Y que este amor,
and that this love,
cada día,
every day,
siga creciendo,
will grow,
manteniéndose el uno al otro unidos,
being one to another together in unity.
Es mi deseo.
It's my wish.
Y mi oración.
And my prayer.
Que así juntos.
That all of us together.
Crezcan en amor.
That you two together will grow in love.
Que tú, Eric.
That you, Eric.
La ames.
Will love her.
Como la estás amando.
Like you love her.
Con todo tu corazón.
With all your heart.
Y tú, Megan.
And you, Megan.
Lo ames.
Love him.
Con todo tu corazón.
With all your heart.
Con todos sus defectos.
Even with his defects.
Y virtudes.
And virtues.
Porque ahora,
because now,
lo tuyo es de ella.
What's yours is hers,
y lo tuyo es de ella.
And what's yours is his.
Amen.
Amen.
Hasta el carro viejito que tiene.
Even the old car that you have.
Todo. Que siempre se acuerden.
Always remember.
De este día.
This day.
Y mantengan.
And remember.
Sus votos.
Your vows.
Y yo te digo, Eric.
And I tell you, Eric,
mi mamá,
my mom
hubiese estado muy orgullosa,
would have been proud
de ti,
of you.
Te has convertido en un gran hombre.
You have become a great man.
Para mí,
and for me,
es una felicidad.
It's a great honor and happiness to see you here. I love you.
Por favor, el lazo.
The lazo.
Esto que vamos a hacer,
this, what we're gonna do,
es una representación,
it's a representation,
de unidad,
of unity,
que siempre,
that always,
estén unidos,
that they will be always together,
en lo bueno,
in good times,
en lo malo,
in bad times,
en la prosperidad,
in prosperity,
y cuando no estén prósperos,
and when they're not prospered,
en todo tiempo,
every time,
en cada momento,
in every moment,
en salud,
in health,
y enfermedad,
and sickness,
que siempre,
that always,
se apoyen,
will support
el uno al otro,
one another.
Amen.
Amen. Viajé mucho para poder tener para este privilegio que se me ha dado hoy.
For you all, it's a dangerous position to have two pastors. You might get to hear two long sermons.
Para varios de nosotros es un poco largo que haya dos pastores porque se hace un poco largo la ceremonia.
Also, a great privilege to be able to work with my brother Edgar in his first wedding, and he did a great job. Amen.
Es también un privilegio para mí poder compartir esta boda con mi hermano pastor Edgar, ya que es su primera boda también.
I want us to think about marriage. Marriage is one of God's greatest gifts.
Quisiera hablar del matrimonio. El matrimonio es un regalo muy grande de Dios.
It is unique as it relates to God's gifts. It is one of the gifts that was given even before the fall.
Y es un regalo que realmente es único, que Dios regaló incluso desde mucho antes.
So in a perfect world, after God created man and woman, he implemented marriage.
Entonces, en el principio, cuando Dios implementó al hombre y a la mujer, él también implementó el matrimonio.
In Genesis 2:24, we get the instruction that a, man shall leave his father and mother and be joined to his wife, and the two shall become one flesh.
En Génesis 2:24 nos dice que el hombre dejará a su padre y madre y se unirá a su mujer y serán una sola carne.
So God's plan is marriage, and it's a great gift.
Así es que el plan de Dios es el matrimonio y es un gran regalo.
Our brother was talking about Ephesians 5.
Nuestro hermano estaba hablando acerca de Efesios 5.
And in Ephesians 5, we get the instruction that first of all, wives be subject to your own husbands as to the Lord.
Y en Efesios 5 dice que las mujeres tienen que estar sujetas a sus maridos, así como el Señor.
And the basis of that is the husband is the head of the wife, as Christ is the head of the church.
Y la base de ese versículo es que el hombre es la cabeza de del hogar, así como Jesús es la cabeza de la iglesia.
And then Eric, we get instruction as husbands, the husbands love your wives just as Christ loved the church.
Y a Eric se le da instrucción de que el hombre ame a su esposa así como Jesús ama a la iglesia.
He loved the church and he gave himself up for her.
Él amó tanto a la iglesia que dio su propia vida por la iglesia.
So marriage is to be a picture of, it certainly relates to a great gift for a man and woman, but it's to be a picture of Christ and what he's done for our salvation.
Así es que el matrimonio es como se relaciona tanto en una unidad, en una unión entre un hombre y una mujer, y así como Jesús también se entregó y dio su vida por la iglesia.
The Bible teaches that marriage is a covenant.
La Biblia también nos enseña que el matrimonio es un pacto.
So while it might not be evident, there's three parties involved today. God, Eric, and Megan are all making a covenant together.
No se podrá ver, pero realmente hoy en este momento es un pacto entre tres, Dios, Eric y Megan.
The Bible also teaches that husbands and wives are equal in value in God's eyes.
La Biblia también nos dice que los maridos y las esposas son de igual valor ante los ojos de Dios.
God has assigned husbands and wives different roles and responsibilities within marriage and the home.
El esposo y la esposa tienen roles diferentes en el matrimonio.
So Megan wives are to submit to their husbands not in a demeaning way, but reverence to the Lord.
Las mujeres o las esposas someterse a sus maridos, pero no en un rol diminutivo.
We as husbands are to love our wives just like Christ loved the church, a sacrificial giving
love. Y Eric, los hombres amaron a sus esposas así como Jesús amó a su iglesia en un amor de sacrificios.
And Megan moved away from home a year or so ago, but husbands and wives are to leave their families and cleave to one another and form a new home.
Megan hace tiempo dejó a su familia y la Biblia dice que el hombre se unirá a su mujer y crearán una nueva familia.
And then the Bible talks about even the intimacy of that you are being one flesh.
Y también habla de que en la intimidad de que los dos vienen a ser una sola carne.
Praise the Lord for the gift of marriage. Let us pray.
Bendecimos a Dios por el regalo del matrimonio. Oremos.
Most holy and merciful Father.
Dios Padre Todopoderoso.
God of nature and of grace.
Dios de la naturaleza y de la gracia.
Creator, preserver, and redeemer of mankind.
Creador y redentor de la humanidad.
We ask you to fill Eric and Megan with a sense.
Te pedimos que llenes a Eric y a Megan con el sentido de la sinceridad del pacto que van a hacer hoy en día.
May they look to you for power and assistance.
Que te busquen a ti para guianza.
And enter into this their sacred obligations and humble dependence upon you.
Y que entren en esta como una dependencia humilde hacia ti.
Grant this, O Father, through Jesus Christ, your Son.
Permítanos a través de tu Hijo Jesucristo.
Our Lord. Amen.
Nuestro Señor. Amén.
I, Eric.
Take you, Megan.
To be my wedded wife.
To be my wedded wife.
To have and to hold. From this day forward. For better or worse. For richer or poorer. In sickness and in health. To love and to cherish. Till death does us part. Megan, would you repeat after me? I, Megan. Take you, Eric. To be my wedded husband. To have and to hold. From this day forward. For better or for worse.
For richer or for poorer.
In sickness and in health. To love. Cherish. And to obey. till death us do part.
Till death us do part.
The exchange of rings. Eric, do you have a token of your vows? Eric, repeat after me. With this ring I thee wed.
With this ring I thee wed.
And with all my worldly goods.
And with all my worldly goods.
I thee endow.
I thee endow.
In the name of the Father.
In the name of the Father.
And of the Son.
And of the Son.
And of the Holy Spirit.
And of the Holy Spirit.
Amen. Amen. Megan, do you have a token of your vows? Megan, would you repeat after me? With this ring I thee wed.
With this ring I thee wed.
And with all my worldly goods.
And with all my worldly goods.
I thee endow.
I thee endow.
In the name of the Father.
In the name of the Father.
And of the Son.
And of the Son.
And of the Holy Spirit.
And of the Holy Spirit.
Amen. Let us pray.
Amen.
Most gracious Heavenly Father, we worship and praise you. We thank you for the gift of covenant marriage. We thank you for the blessing, Eric, for blessing Eric and Megan to be able to enter into this covenant before you this day.
Te damos gloria y honra, Señor, y te damos gracias porque en este momento podemos ver que Eric y Megan pueden entrar en un nuevo pacto hacia ti.
We ask you to pour out your grace upon them.
Te pedimos que los bendigas y que los llenes de tu gracia.
We pray you will bless and protect their marriage.
Oramos que protejas su matrimonio.
We pray that you will make their marriage and their home a testimony of your greatness.
Y oramos que hagas su matrimonio y su hogar un ejemplo para otras personas.
And your faithfulness.
En tu lealtad.
We pray that their marriage would bear testimony of Jesus Christ.
Oramos que su matrimonio sea testimonio de nuestro Señor Jesucristo.
Pray this in his name.
Y oramos esto en su nombre.
Amen.
Amen.
Jesus said,
Jesús dijo,
what therefore God has joined together,
lo que Dios unió,
let no man separate.
Que nada, que ningún hombre lo separe.
Based on the authority of the word of God,
basándome en la autoridad de, nuestro, de la palabra de nuestro Dios,
and in as much as Eric and Megan,
y a Eric y a Megan,
have consented together in holy matrimony,
que han consentido en unirse al matrimonio,
and have witnessed the same before God and this company,
y han tenido testigos en frente de todos nosotros,
and have given and pledged themselves each to the other,
y se han unido el uno al otro,
and have declared the same by giving and receiving rings,
y han declarado al intercambiar anillos,
I pronounce that they are husband and wife.
Los proclamo marido y mujer.
In the name of the Father.
En el nombre del Padre.
And of the Son,
del Hijo,
and of the Holy Spirit,
y del Espíritu Santo.
Amen.
Amen.
Eric, you may kiss your bride.
Eric, puedes besar a la novia.
There must be a God. I believe it's true, 'cause I can see His love when I look at you. And He must have a plan for this crazy life, 'cause He brought you here and placed you by my side. And I have never been so sure of anything before.
Well, I just want to say some words before I go. I am so happy to be here tonight. Soy muy contento de estar aquí hoy, ya que uno de mis amigos, since one of my best friends, Eric, which I also feel like he's my brother, one of my brothers, he got married today. I know that I'm supposed to be like the best man of honor or so, but I do think or believe that Gustavo, his brother, has been there the whole time, even before I was there. And I think he knows Eric better than I do. So that's why at this moment I would like to pass it to him so he can say some other insights about Eric.
Hello, everyone.
Hi. As everybody heard and knows, como todos saben y han oído, soy el hermano de Eric, el segundo hermano. I am Eric's the middle child, the forgotten one. You know, he's the youngest one. He's the oldest. I'm the middle of the forgotten one. Él es el mayor, él es el menor, y yo soy el del medio, el olvidado. Well, I just want to share something really quick. I mean, I'm really proud that my brother, he has followed his dream. Estoy muy orgulloso de mi hermano porque realmente ha seguido su sueño. Se movió desde Beloit a una iglesia para trabajar en la obra del Señor, y eso es algo grandioso, un cambio radical totalmente. He left Beloit to move 2.5 hours away to work on the church, and it's one of the greatest things he has ever done. He has followed his dream, and I remember one. I mean, since we lived for like what 14 years or so, I remember the time when he actually was talking to Megan. They were Skyping. He was really wise about it, according to him. Recuerdo cuando estaba iniciaba él tener pláticas con Megan por medio de la computadora por Skype, y él sentía que quizás estaba haciéndolo muy escondido, que nadie se enteraba. Entonces un día escuché murmullos. I remember one day I was in my room and I heard noises, like somebody was talking. So I'm like, I wonder what he's doing. So, y yo me pregunto qué estará haciendo. So me levanté un día en la noche y me hice como que iba a tomar agua. So one night I kind of faked it, but I'm thirsty, I need to go and get water. So as soon as I open up the door, I hear a phrase saying, okay, quiet. So recuerdo cuando me desperté, me levanté y abrí la puerta, escuché una frase que dijo, okay, espérate, cállate, no hables. So I walked towards the fridge and I drank something, went back, and I saw him in the living room with his computer talking to somebody. And recuerdo porque fui a la cocina, tomé y hago, y ya cuando regresé, él estaba en la sala viendo su computadora. So right there, I'm like, yeah, he already met somebody. He just doesn't want to tell anyone. He's like, oh, it's a big secret. Like, nobody needs to find out. I recuerdo esa noche lo vi y él pensó que nadie se había dado cuenta. Later, I remember that he calls me and he tells me, hey, I meet you at a restaurant in Rockford. I invited Edgar and I invited David. Y recuerdo que me dijo un día, te invito a un restaurante ahí en Rockford, invité a Edgar, invité a David. Le digo, okay. And I had an idea what was gonna happen. I just didn't know that he was really serious. Yo sabía que iba a pasar, o sea, que nos iba a presentar a alguien, pero nunca pensé que iba a ser ya algo muy serio. And from the bottom of my heart, brother, we've been through a lot. The fun for us stops here, but you start a new story with her. And it's gonna be even better. Nuestra, nosotros ya aquí terminó, somos hermanos, ya nuestra corrida ya aquí termina, pero empiezas una nueva y es algo mucho mejor. Va a ser una muy buena aventura. It's gonna be the greatest adventure that you are going to have in your life. Having this amazing woman right next to you, it's the best gift that God has ever given to you. Es el mejor regalo que Dios te ha dado, o esta mujer que tienes aquí al lado. I'd like to thank Chip and Melissa. You have raised a fine woman. Ever since I met her, I'm like, she's really amazing. I mean, she has the courage to withstand Eric. Where else can I say? Cuando la conocí, dije, es una muy buena mujer. Tiene el coraje de aguantar a Eric. ¿Qué más se puede pedir? So, thank you. Thanks for everything. You guys have been a huge blessing. Thanks, Megan. I mean, it's words cannot explain what I feel. I'm so happy for the two of you. Thank everybody for coming to today and share this wonderful moment with you. Gracias a todos por venir y por estar en este momento tan agradable para mi hermano. May God bless everybody. Dios les bendiga. And now,
unlike Eric, Megan was very open about how she felt with Eric to many of us around. And so we knew from the very beginning, from when he came from Beloit to here, Cool Rapids, for a mission trip. And from there, we kept picking on her because there was something, and then she's hiding text messages just for a little bit. And she's like, it's not a big deal. But really, it was a big deal for her because she thought there was something serious going on. And so being able to watch this from the very beginning, from the first date to now, it's been a journey. So, but Megan, even though I'm going to miss not only living with you, but our many times of waking up at 5 a.m. in college to go run, and then you putting up with me when I say we need to wake up at 4, and then when we sat there and just watched Reba, and you tell me I can't flip the couch at night, and all the other things. But you really have been a sister to me, and you've been there through some of my worst moments and through some of my best, and probably more of my worst. And I just thank you for allowing me to be a part of your life in a big way that probably is, I don't know how much has impacted you, but I know you've impacted me in ways that I probably don't always share. And so I do want to thank you for just not only being my friend, but just being there with my sister in Christ and encouraging me through different things that I just wanted to be a pessimist about and be negative about. And Eric, I thank you for loving her for who she is and for encouraging her to be who she is and allowing her to be who she is and just continuing to love her through all of the good times and the bad times. And just know that there's many of us in here that love you and we're praying for you guys and that we're always here for you. So don't ever act like we're not here. We'll come find you.
Now in
so,
Spanish.
We love you. I don't know Spanish. I'm sorry.
Quick funny story. When they were taking their pictures for engagement, they asked me to write wedding in there. Very fancy. And I forgot the N. So I said wedding. Close enough. During summer, Megan asked me if I could write them like a poetic story. And she read a lot of my stuff. She's like, can you write something for my wedding? I'm like, sure. Challenge accepted. All right, so. Today's theme, anyone's dream could be a story. Just like a spark on a computer, there can be a spark between two people. It's funny how all of this happened over a simple question. Is your computer broken? After a while of texting and talking, then came the random morning texting. But Over time, she questioned herself, what exactly is this? And later herself, if this is a thing, then he will text me. And shortly after, his message came by and through and lit her phone. If you truly love someone, distance is not to be worried about, especially if you're 2.5 hours apart. There will always be a place to meet. Like half a heart, they both went half ways, just to look into each other's eyes. And where did these two meet? The state's capital, Madison. After 2 hours of sitting on a bench, something just seemed to click. Who knew that two hazel eyes, both full of green and brown, yet different, would look at each other and end up in love? When you're a girl and you really like a guy, your friends will surely know. Trust me, they'll know. First, they see you always smiling when his name is mentioned or when he texts you. Then you'll talk nonstop about him. When they're true friends, they'll be honest with you. They will support you, help you out, and stick together like peanut butter and jelly. I bet he's going to tell you, you're one in a million. Believe it or not, she was right. And later they laughed about it. As any lovebird out there, they loved watching movies together, going out to get a bike together, and they also loved quality time. You guessed it, together. The smile, the compassion for people, the goofiness, the willingness to check if she's okay. And the name, he couldn't remember. Hello, Jelena. Heather. Wait a minute. The two friends looked at each other. Maybe one of them is called Heather. One, two, nine of them passed. None. No one was called Heather. As confused as they were, they moved on. The morning, JoJo made us cinnamon rolls. And let me say, you loved eating your buns. And they were good. The eyes that can look into eyes and look through them like windows into his soul. The nerdiness that comes from watching the clever doctor run. And most importantly, and most favorite, the accent. The night of the proposal, she had two thoughts. He'll never do it. And on the night of the memorable night, oh my gosh, is he going to break up with me? Boy, was she wrong. Two different nationalities, two different families are now united as one. You have found your one true one piece. So run. Run, you clever boy, and remember never to forget why you fell. And when I interviewed them, I asked them, give me words that describe each other or your relationship. And they said, calm, lava, storm, crazy but not like a hurricane, both hot, whirlwind, she goes with the wind, fire.
And I have been together since we were little babies, and I love her so much, and I am happy for Eric and Megan, and I know she will always be my sister, no matter what. But I love you all, and congratulations.
Everything she ever wanted, all those dreams, and now they're finally here. She's so young and he's so perfect. They waited for love and it was worth it. She wants to feel like this for 100 years. All this.
got blue eyes just like her brother. He's always crazy for her. He wants to freeze this day before it's a new one.
Thank you. her. Just through and tell us all they had planned. She says that it's 6 months away. I need to practice my dancing. Oh, please, daddy, please. So I'm
thank you. there is none upon the earth. And I desire before you, Lord, for you've been faithful all my days. Your love endures, it will never fade.